एंड आई स्टार्टेड माई सेकेंड ट्यूटोरियल विच इज रिलेटेड टू द इंटरप्रिटेशन. सो इन दैट वन
इंटरप्रिटेशन.
वी हैव टू कैप्चर द पैकेट्स इन द वायरशार्क. सो फॉर द कैप्चरिंग ऑफ द पैकेट यू हैव टू स्टार्ट द वायरशार्क. सो फर्स्टली ओपन द वायरशार्क एंड हियर आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दिस इज द इंटरफेस स्पेस. लाइक यू हैव टू बी यूज द वायरशार्क ऑन द इथरनेट और इट इज टोटली डिपेंड्स अपॉन द पर्सन. लाइक इट कैन बी यूज ऑन द वाई फाई ऑल्सो. नेक्स्ट इज दैट वन लाइक सपोज यू आर कैप्चरिंग द पैकेट. सो दिस वन इज टू बी द स्टार्टिंग पेन. लाइक सपोज आई एम स्टार्टिंग माई वायरशार्क. तो दिस इज आर इंटरफेस and suppose I want to start my Wireshark on the Wi-Fi, double click on it and it is the starting and it is the stopping pane. And that same is shown in my word file. This is the starting. When you want to start, if you want to stop, so click on this one square sign. Next is the filtering packets. So the packets is that is the most important part in the Wireshark. Like suppose you have to be send the packets from source to the destination. So that one particular packet is to be captured. Like if you want to trying to inspect some specific traffic or you can want like some sending the program or you want to send some type of packet from source to a destination. So you have to apply the display filters or you can apply the filtering packets. Like when it shows in my this one doc file, here is the DNS is to be in the filter. So it can be only be shown you the protocol related to the DNS. So if you want to analyze this one packet, so you have to be click on analyze. After that, you have to be click on the display filters. Okay, then choose a filter from the among one. So go to the Wireshark, go to the analyze, and after display filters, click on it. It shows you the same screen as that in the screenshot. This is the display filters. In this one display filter, it is related to the information related to the that one which is the DNS, because you type the filter packets for the DNS. Another interesting thing is that when TCP is present is already here, because TCP stream is the most important. Every time you can say that every protocol is working most of the time on the TCP, because you want a connection oriented type of service. So that's why you are using the TCP. When I click on this one,
yes? Quick question. So this display filters, this is why we need to use this one. So this is an helping portion that for us, that okay, what type
yeah,
of filter
for the do? Yeah, for the yeah display filter, suppose you want do not want to use the display filter. So in that one case, in my Wireshark, when I click on the starting packet, so it can capture around 1 minute 450. Okay, so this will be very difficult for me, like related to the TCP or any type of protocol. So that's why I'm using the display filter. Suppose I write here TCP, it can only be give me about the TCP related information. Okay. That's why we use the display filters.
Makes sense.
Okay, so now this is the TCP stream. We are already discussed about the TCP, that the TCP is the connection oriented type of services. So that's why when you are working with the TCP stream, that means you can send the packets one by one a continuously way. So that's why there is a stream working. This is all about the TCP stream. If you want to check the TCP stream, so there is, you can go to the follow and TCP stream in this one. Okay. Well, this is all about the information about the TCP, UDP and all these things. If you want to add something, so you can be click on this one and add a display filter also. Like suppose you want to display filter, you are opening some website and there is no a different type of displays present. So you can add your own filter here with the click on the plus one sign. Now the next thing is that when after displaying filter, you can find out the inspecting packets. Like suppose what packet you have to be captured, so you have to be inspecting that one. Like click on the packet and after that you can see the details in the third one pane, because in the Wireshark three important panes are present. First is the packet pane, second one is the packet bytes or the packet information, third one is in the byte forms. So when you click on the packet, like suppose you want to get the information of the single packet, so you have to be click on this one and here is the all the information are present in the second one column. You can also create your own filters. Just click one of the details you want to apply the filter. Like suppose you want to click go to this one and right click on it, and if you want mark and unmark, ignore, set, something, like you can do anything. If you want to apply as a filter, So you can be select this one. So every time when the TCP is to be selected, so TCP is to be in the filter already present. So it can capture, okay, give you the
what TCP. What does this mark and unmark packet do? I select mark or unmark, meaning that only this
can
one
be
will
mark. It can change the color of the TCP, no? Because you mark this one.
Okay, got it. So this mark is actually helping us to finding
highlight
a packet,
something.
For example.
Yeah, highlight something. No? This is the next is the color coding. I already told you that color coding is the also the important part, because with the help of color coding, you can easily highlight something. Like suppose blue color represents the UDP and green color represents the TCP. So every person after checking the color coding and colorization, it can be understand like that, okay, this packet belongs to this one protocol. So here you will probably see the packets highlighted in the various type of different colors. So Wireshark uses the colors to identify the traffic basically.
Okay.
Suppose if you find the errors in the Wireshark, so that one error is comes with the black color. So that means you can easily understand like, okay, this one packets the error. After that, when you analyze all the things and all the information, so you have to be know like, okay, here is the reset flag or something like different type of information you have to be got after analyzing the packets. But with the help of a color, you can go to the overview like, okay, this packet contains some errors.
Okay.
Now, next thing is that one, suppose you want to change the color, because this is the colors by default. If you want to change the permanently colorization or something, so you have to firstly select the view. After that, colorizing rules. So here are different type of rules are present. So here we are clicking on the view. Here is the coloring rules. Click on it. All the rules are presented here. Now, if you want to select your own rule, like suppose you want, I want that there is a DNS is present. So DNS color is to be changed or something like that one. So you have to be add your own here. Like suppose click on this one. Here you can use new color rule for the DNS. Okay, so DNS will be in the green color if it is present. So you can check it on and click on OK. If there is DNS is present here, so it will be in the green color. We have to check like if there is a DNS is present or not. So you see DNS is to be the green color because I set for this one. But in this one, there is no DNS packets. If I found DNS, so I will show you.
Okay.
So next is that one, like suppose you want to change the color. So you have to be go to the view. And after that, you can go to the coloring rules. And Wireshark will display the coloring rules. Like what type of rules are to be made here. Like suppose for the bad TCP, it gives you the black color. If there is any ARP or the ICMP, it gives you the light pink color. If you want to check, like suppose for the TCP RST. RST means the reset. Yeah, that means your port number is to be blocked or something condition happens. So your TCP is to be in the reset mode. If there is any checksum error, it can be give you the black color. Now, if you want to create the new rule, so you have to be click on the plus one button. And after that, you can click your new rules.
Okay.
Now, you can add a rule by double clicking on the name or filter. The name of the rule for the checksum is to be edited. Like suppose when you want to change the color. You open that one. No. Close this one and go to the view, then coloring rules. And suppose I want to change the color for something like which one? TCP. Double click on it. Here, if you want to change the color, so you go to the background. If you want to change the background color, if you want to change the foreground color, so you have to click on this one and choose any other. Like suppose I this one for the and background, I choose like this one. Okay. Suppose I choose here, right? When I write the HTTP, so it can change the color, but here is no HTTP. Wait, you see the pinkish color when I type the HTTP because I changed this one.
Okay.
Suppose I start the Wireshark again and open any HTTP website. Okay, minimize this one. Stop the Wireshark. Yeah. Okay, so when we want to change the color, so you have to be create your own next rule. That is not, that is the previous rule is already defined for the HTTP. That's why it not be taken. Like suppose you want to change the rule, so you have to delete that first one and after that create for the HTTP or any other type of protocol. And you have to be, if you want, so you can be change the foreground or the background color. Background color is used for only the display filter. Foreground color is that one which is present in the packet pane. Next is the enabled protocols. Basically, enabled, all the things are related to the protocols. Protocols are that one which is a set of rules which can be run into the Wireshark or the different type of, you can say that a different type of network monitoring tools. So in the enabled protocol dialog box, if you want to enable or disable the protocols, like suppose you want that this protocol is not to be captured by the Wireshark. So you have to be click on that one and disable it. For enable or disable protocol, you have to be go to the in the analyze things. After that analyze, you have to do the enable protocols or disable. So go to the analyze. Here is the enable protocol present. Click on it. Here is the all the protocols and all the information are presented here. If you want to disable something, like suppose, wait, in that one, I close this one and remove this one and enter. You have to be see here is a UDP is already present. Okay, so suppose I want to remove the UDP. So it cannot be capture the UDP packet after that when I start the Wireshark. So click on the analyze, enable or disable protocol and search is for the UDP. UDP is presented here. But here is a different type of UDPs are present. So you have to be checked. Like suppose if you are working in the company and your company wants like, okay, this type of traffic, you have to be blocked or related to the this websites, that one traffic is to be blocked. So firstly, analyze all the things. And after that, when you analyze all the things, so you have to be know, okay, this traffic is comes from this one websites. So you have to be block them with the help of enable or the disable type of protocols. Because in that one, there are various types of UDP present. But in if you want this one Wireshark for the company purpose, so in that one case, only HTTP protocols are to be used for the enabling or the disabling. Because with the help of HTTP, there are the various types of viruses and worms comes to your network. So that's why this is the mandatory. Like suppose you have to be any doubt like, okay, this website contains some of the malicious codes or something like that one. So you have to be go to the enable protocol and after that disabling this one. This is the same screenshot which I show you in my Wireshark. In that one, there are various options are present. Enable all, that means you want all the protocols in your list. Disable all, that means you don't want any type of protocol. So that's why you can disable it. Invert means toggle the state of all protocol. That means you have to be monitoring all the steps. Okay for the saving, cancel for the deletion. If okay. You want a user specified decodes, basically decode and encoding means you want to get the information about in the simple form. So you have to decode this one. So the decode as functionality lets you temporarily divert specific protocol dissection. That means if you want another type of information related to the values or this one value comes into the integer form or in the decimal form, in the binary form. So you have to be go to the decode as. So for the decode as, you have to be click on the analyze and after that decode as. So when I click on the Wireshark, after that this one in the analyze, after that you have to be click on the decode as. When you click on the decode as, but here there is no decode as is present because decode as is working is on the SIP protocols. SIP is the SIP, which is the IP calling. Like suppose you are making your own servers and you have to be use the calling purpose. Okay, like suppose you make two servers. One server IP is suppose 10.1 and second server IP is 10.2. And you want like you have to be communicate with the help of these two servers over the internet. Like no one is recording your call because all the voice calls has to be recorded. This is everyone know. but we know that WhatsApp is the encrypted, but at some time no one has to be hacked the WhatsApp, hack the WhatsApp calling. That means you cannot be here. But in the case of normal calling, so normal calling towers have to be, if you want, so you can be hacked to the towers for knowing that what the person has to be talking between that person. So in that one case, in the decode as, it can be only used in the SIP calling. If you able to make the servers or if you are able to make the two servers, and if you want to communicate these two servers and you want to hear like what the person is going on the call and something like that one, so you have to be use the decode as things. But in that one case, like if you want to set up, so this is not your part. Your part is to only using the Wireshark to get the information. For the server part and for the another part, the person has to be present to make the server. After that, you can run the Wireshark and decode that one, like what that person using in their call and what type of talking they want. Okay, so with the help of decode as, you can do this one. So in the decode dialog box, you have to be know some type of information, like you want to add something. Add something, that means it can only be at the SIP calling. If there is any type of calling is already present, like SIP calling and different one, so you have to be add that one. After that, if you want to remove that one SIP calling, so you can be click on the minus sign to remove this one. Like suppose I show you, here is the plus and the minus sign is already present. But here in my Wireshark, there is no SIP calling is present. That's why there is no adding here. If there is a adding present, so we can be remove here. That's why his remove sign is disabled. Next is the clear. Clear means you can decode all the things. Okay, that means you are okay to that one, and save and cancel. Next is defining and saving filters. Like suppose you want to save the filters. So there are, you are already know that there are previously made filters are already present in the Wireshark. But suppose you want to check your filters or you want to add your filters. So in that one case, you have to be go to the edit or create capture filter. After that, select the manage capture filters from the capture filter, bookmark or anything you want to do from the main menu. Main menu, every person know that front one is the main menu, which is contains the file and all the things which contains in the main menu. So 1 minute, I'll show you how can you add this one. Go to the Wireshark. Yeah, if you want to create or edit something, so firstly you have to be go to the manage capture filters, like click on the edit, and here is, I think so, there is the option present. In the capture, there is a manage, in the analyze, in the capture filter. This is the plus sign. Okay, if you want to add a bookmark, like suppose you want to add something very prior, suppose you add here the TCP. So when every time when you capture all the packets, so TCP is to be in the front line, because you already add the TCP as the bookmark. It is same as that when you apply the bookmark in the Google, like every time it can be shows in the display. So you can be created by creator on the plus one sign. After that, you can add the display filter in your main menu. Every time when you open the website, so different type of things, so you can be add with the help of the bookmarking. Yeah, with the help of plus one sign, you can add the filter. If you want to delete this one, copy, cancel, save. These type of things like copy, cancel, save, plus, minus, in the every time of filtration, you can do this one in the case of interpretation. One thing you have to be know, like in the Wireshark, you have to be very careful about that one, because every time when you go for the interview type, or if any person wants to learn the Wireshark and all these things, so in that one, all the theory topic related to this one main menu, because all the information and all the important things are only be placed in the file or this one. If you want to change like what the type of time and number or source and important destination is to be shown, so you have to be create your own thing, like you want to change this one. Suppose you want to add any other column or something, so you have to be click on this one. Wait, here is the option present, like in the edit, no? Copy, no set on set. Here is the that one part is present to add the column. Okay, when I found this one, so I will show you. Next is that one for after the interpretation, if you want to analyze your statistics. Statistics related to that one, like suppose you have to be captured different type of packets, and after that there is a different type of analysis also present. Like you can send a packet from source to a destination, like 10 packets. So in that one case, you have to analyze your whole statistics. Statistics gives you a graph or different type of things in your protocol means. So in the statistics, there is a hierarchy, columns are present. First column is the protocol. That is, it gives you the all the protocols name, like what protocols you are using. Percent packet, that means what what amount of percentage of packets you have to be sent. Third one is the packets, like total number of packets in the number. First one is for in the percentage form, second one is the number form. After that is the percentage bytes, because all the packets are sent from one point to the next one point in the in the bytes form. Bytes is the size. Next one is the percentage bytes, that means it gives you the bytes in the percentage. Next is the bytes. Bytes means the number of bytes. Bits is the also the smallest units unit related to the bytes. Next is the end packet, like what is the end packet which you send. End bytes, that means what is the size, and end bits is also the size. If you want to check, so you have to be only click on this one and go to the statistics. Here is also say the protocol hierarchy. Click on the protocol hierarchy, it gives me the all the protocols. Packet percentage, that means percentage in all the packets have to be sent in the percentage amount. This one is the number of packets. Percentage bytes, that means size of the particular packet in the percentage form. Here is in the number form, here is in the bit forms. So this is about the protocol hierarchy. Click on this one. This is all about the protocol hierarchy, that what type of column is present in the protocol hierarchy. Packets usually contain multiple protocols, because you can see in the Wireshark, if I capture the different type of packets, so it can be related to the different type of protocol. One is using the TCP, another is using the UDP, and third one is also using the DHCP or something like different type of protocol. So in that one case, you have to be know about that at what type of protocol sending which amount of data. So in the screenshot, you can see IP sending the 99.9% of data, but TCP sending the 98.5% of data. So protocol layer can consist of different type of packet, which is related to different type layer of protocols, like the HTTP, TLS, that is the transport layer security, TCP, UDP, and different type of packets you can be seen. But if you want to see the graphs or something like that one, so you have to be click on this one. And go to the, again the statistics and click on the IO graphs. IO graphs related to the input output graphs. When you click on this, it gives you the graph related to the all packets are represented by this one color. TCP errors, if there is a present, so that can be represented with the help of red color. If there are filter packet, because I using related to the TCP related things, so TCP is to be with the brownish color. If you want your another thing, so you have to be click on this one, and here you have to be write like suppose HTTP. In the display filter, you have to be again as the HTTP enter. So if there is any HTTP website is present here, so it can be give you as the blue color representation. Like suppose click on it this also. So here is any type of blue color, it should be shown in your screen. Like suppose I want to change this color also. So it green. Okay, so this is the HTTP, this green sign, that means you also shows the different type of protocols on the graph if you want. So different type of protocols are shown in your graph. It's like suppose any UDP, TCP, DHCP, any type of protocol if you are using in your Wireshark. So you have to be set this one. Here you have to add the graph name and also the display filter. If you want to change the color, so you have to be click on this one. And after that, different type of colors are shown in the graph. This is known as the IO graph. IO means input output. That means you want to change your that means you want to show your graphs in the case of the protocols. So you can be add here. Enabled, that means draw or don't draw the graph. Graph name, when I add this one, HTTP is my graph name. Display filter, I already use the HTTP. If I want to change the color, so we can change on the color and graph lines. If I want to change the style also, so there is already the option also present. Yeah, this one. This is the line form. Okay. If I want to change the line form, click on it one. There is the options are present. Dot or something square. So it can be changed there. This one as in the square. If you want to save this one, so there is a name. And after that, you can save on the desktop also. Save as this. So in the, wait. Yeah, this is in the form of the PDF. All the things are present. Wait, I'll show you. This is my graph, okay? And it is present in the square form. This is the square. Because I changed the TCP line into the square form. So you can be check here. Next is the after y-axis and all these things, because graph is considered about the x and the y-axis. So packet, bytes or bits. All these three are the same things, but different on the basis of the amount. Like suppose bit is the smallest unit, after that byte comes and next is the packet. Packet is that one which is working on the third layer or the fourth layer. Bytes is the where the previous things and bits is also the lowest things. So in the case like you want to sum the values in the Y field per interval, count frames, count fields, all these things are present in the graph. Like you want to share the graph, so you have to be changing the different type of colors of the protocol. And after that, save the graph as in the PDF form and send the person. So in that one, all the information are presented with the help of graph. Here is the graph. So you can be check like different type of packets are presented. And this is the for the TCP errors or there is a HTTP is present or not. So you have to be represented with the square and all these things are present in the graph. So this is only for the input output graphs. If you want to add something, so I already add in front of you for the HTTP. If you want to delete that one, so you have to be click on the minus sign. If you want to clear, remove anything, you can be do. Switch between a logarithmic or the linear y-axis. So y-axis is that one, like horizontal line is the x-axis and this is the y-axis. This is the y and this is the x-axis. So you have to be take the packet one per second, like what type of packets you have to be sent by per second. That means 150, sometimes 200, sometimes above the 300, these type of packets can be sent into the 1 by 1 seconds. Next is the resolved address. Resolved address window shows you the list of resolved address and their host names. That means if you want to send something with the help of IPv4 or the IPv6 version, in that one case, a dialog display host name is to become. Enable resolve network. If you want to resolve something addresses, so you have to be go to the view and name resolution menu. Go to here. View. Here is the main toolbar. All things are interconnecting to each other. Yes. Here is if you want to resolve your address. Resolve basically means your destination IP, because you have to be send a packet from source to a destination. In the Wireshark, you have to be know, like you have to focus on only the source address. In the case, suppose you want to send the address from one point to the another one, the resolving address is your destination address, because without destination, you cannot be send a particular thing to the destination. So if you want to check your resolve address, so you have to be double click on the resolving address. Either you have to be click on the view and name resolution menu. Name resolution menu is set up by default. That means you cannot be set up because it can be disabled by the default. If you want to select external network name, like suppose you want to change your resolution. So it will be, you can be changed. Like suppose when I capture the packets into the different form. Wait, I close this one. Yes, here where this is my source IP here and this is my destination. So destination IP is my laptop IP, but the source IPs belong to that one site which I open. But this is the UDP. So that means this is that one which I capture the packets one by one, not related to the TCP. When I open the click here HTTP. So in that one case, this is my source IP and this is the destination IP. So destination IP is the resolve address where you want to query for some time. Here is the protocol streams are present. So basically the meaning of stream is that one, like you want to send 5 or 10 packets at a single time. So that is the stream. Like continuously you are sending the packets one by one. So this comes in the form of the stream. If you send one packets at the same time, so that means this is related to the single thing. So in that one case, suppose you are sending the continuously packets. So in that case, like there is a website which contains a server. So at single time, server can only be enabled or can only be served 10 packets. Okay. So at that particular time, suppose you are sending 100 packets. So in that one case, only you can send the packets into the synchronization mode because you are synchronizing to the server. But at that particular time, server did not give you any type of acknowledgement. So in that one case, there is a performing DOS attack. And that one time, DOS attack is to be represented in the green color or something like that. In the black color, because that one is the error contains. Because your server has only be the capacity of the 10 user, but you are bombarding again and again the packets. So in that one case, server is not able to give you the things. So that particular packets you have to be sent, now that one is the stream, because you are sending the again and again in the continuous manner packets. So that one is the DOS attack, because you don't you not get any type of acknowledgement. But you have to be either check like that particular packet protocol is the TCP or the UDP. Suppose you are sending the UDP packets, or there are some types of UDP packets are present. So in that one case, there is no acknowledgement. So not that one, that is also the DOS attack. This is the UDP packets. But the protocol is the TCP and you are sending the packets again and again. There is no acknowledgement. So you have to be declared that this is the strictly DOS attack. That is the protocol stream. If you want to check the stream or changing the color and fonts, all these things, so I will already show you. You have to go to the view, and if you want to change the thing, so you have to go to the colorizing rules, and after that you have to create your own rule for changing the colors. Next thing is for the configuration profiles. Here is the, you can also be use the sign, like suppose Control Shift A or something like that one. Otherwise you have to be go to the edit, and after that configuration profile. This is our configuration profile, that means default or something like that one. Configuration profile, that means you want to resemble something, only you want to show the protocols in the highlighted mode. So you have to be click your configuration. Configuration profile can be used to configure more than one set of preferences or configuration. That means you want that like your TCP or something like of protocol, it should be in the manner. Like, okay, this one is your dialog box, so that one appear again and again. Like suppose you can add in the bookmark section, like only the TCP is present here. So TCP is the, you can say TCP is already be shown again and again. So TCP is the bookmarking. Same as that in the configuration profile. If you want, so you can be use the configuration profile as your bookmark. So after that, when you sending the packet from one point to the another point, so every time a TCP or something like protocol, when you add it, so it can be shown in your main screen as a dialog box. So this is the screen which I'll already show you, like default and all this. If you want to search the profile, so here is the option present, type here and search. If you want to type the selection, like this is for the personal or for the global. These are two different things. Personal, that means you want that, okay, this is only for my personal uses. Global, that means these are provided by the Wireshark. That means which are defaultly added. Those are global profiles, and which you can add. So that is the personal profile. With the help of new sign, that is the plus one, you can add, delete, copy, import. Import means you want to send that one. Export, which you want, like I am creating and all these things, I am exporting you. After that, when you click on this one and import in your Wireshark. Okay, cancel, help are already present in every time. Okay, so this is all related to the interpretations and analyzing statistics. Okay, next thing is basically related to our protocols. So here is a different type of protocol you have to be studied, like DHCP, DNS, Telnet, SMTP, and many more. So one by one, we have to be described like what type of protocols are present in our network. Okay, so everything you have to understand now. Anything which have you doubt, so you can ask me. After that, when I start, we have start the protocols.
No, I have no doubts.
Okay, so Sunny, tell me about the DHCP. That what the DHCP and how the DHCP work. Anything which you know about the DHCP. Yes, Sunny, tell me the DHCP or something like that one. Different type of protocols you have to study today. So we have to be know, like what type of protocols are present in our network.
Okay. So DHCP stands for Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol.
Okay.
And it's actually a network management protocol, which is used the internet protocol networks, right? Which is actually used to automatically assigning IP addresses and other communication parameters to the devices. This
okay,
is pretty
so
much, right?
Suppose DHCP is not able to give you the IP. So in that one case, what happened?
If DHCP is not giving us the IP, then we have to manually create our IP or something.
So in that one case, there is no IP is defined. Like suppose DHCP failed to give you the IP address. So in that one case, what range of IP you have to be given?
What range of IP?
Yeah. Basically, can you please tell me like what's the role of the DHCP? Firstly,
it's actually what is the role of DHCP, right?
Why we are using this one?
For managing the, assigning IP addresses to the devices that's been collected.
Okay. Okay, that is the correct one. Like you can give the dynamic IP. But suppose when DHCP not fails to give you the IP address. So in that one case, what's your IP address? 0000?
Not really. That in that sense, your local host will be your IP, right?
Like one, local host IP, that means?
127.0.0.1 something.
No. I will tell you. Basically, when DHCP fails to give you the IP address, so in that one case, APIPA gives you the IP address. Okay. APIPA is that one like default IP address. In that one case, like DHCP is not connected in your system. So that IP range starts from the 169 range. 169.10 dot something like that one. But it can start from the 169. Okay. So that one means DHCP is not able to give you the IP address. So in that one case, APIPA give you the IP address. But with the help of APIPA, you cannot be connected in the internet. That means you have to be check your internet connection and all these things. And you have to be set up the dynamic host configuration protocol. Okay. This is the DHCP. Okay. Now tell me about the DNS.
DNS is a domain name server.
Okay. What is the function? Well, this is the full form, no?
Yeah. So it's actually translate request for names into IP addresses. So controlling which server an end user is will reach when they type a domain name into their web browser. So, for example, if you say google.com, so it will translate that google.com into an IP address.
That means it can be resolving the IP to the domain to IP, no?
Yes. Yes. Okay. Something
what
similar
is,
to yes.
Okay. ARP.
So ARP is address resolution protocol. So which is actually a communication protocol used for discovering the link layer addresses, such as like MAC address associated with the device, something.
That means it is resembled to the DNS. In that one case, like DNS using the resolving between the IP and to the domain, but it can resolve the MAC address to the particular.
Yes.
Okay. So, okay, next is ICMP. What is this?
ICMP is internet control message protocol.
Yeah. Yes.
So it's actually a supporting protocol in the internet protocol suite. It is used by network devices like
why we are using the ICMP, like where we are using the ICMP, no? That means this protocol, like suppose I want to check my HTTP protocol. So in that one case, I searching some websites, and after that HTTP protocol has shown me in my Wireshark. So same case, where I can see the ICMP protocols.
We can give an example of like when you do the pink utility. So yeah, it's actually correct. Sending that ICMP.
That is the pink packet. Pink packets are resembled to the ICMP. Okay, what is the HTTP protocol?
It is actually a hypertext transfer protocol. So basically the internet that we are using, I mean browsing, is HTTP.
Okay, so what's the difference between basically in the HTTP and the HTTPS?
So HTTP is not secured. HTTPS is secured version of HTTP.
Okay. What's the protocol? What's the port number? It can be used by HTTP and HTTPS.
HTTP is using 80, port 80. HTTPS is 443.
Okay. Next is FTP. What is FTP?
File transfer protocol to transfer file from device to device. So we can use that file transfer protocol.
Okay. Example of some mail protocols. Today I take some review, no? After that I will show you.
Okay. Mail protocols, right?
Yeah. Example of something, like what mail protocols are considered here.
Like SMTP, IMAP, POP3.
Yeah, good. These are related to the mail protocol. So these type of protocols we have to be learned here. But in that one case, we can only be identify the TCP/IP protocol. DNS we can do ARP, IPv4, that is the IP version, ICMP, DHCP, HTTP. These type of protocol I will show you the practically. But FTP and mail transfer and all the wireless LANs and all these things, voice capture, we cannot be do. Because in the FTP, we want the file transfer servers, like we can want two type of server which can sending the file. In the mail protocols, we have to be also develop the mail transfer servers. That is the SMTP. Like if you want to capture the voice calls and all these things, so in that one case, you already have to be set up the two servers which can be contact to each other. So these are the technical parts related to the hardware. So that is the working which is done by the hardware engineer or any other person. Because we have to be only run the Wireshark, we have to do the software part. Okay, so we have to be capture these packets one by one. And after that, we have to be analyze like what type of information we have to be get.
Okay.
Clear. So this is the protocol analysis. So protocol analysis, we have to be stuck like that one. Okay, we have to be capture one by one the packets. Like same as that one. Suppose I start my Wireshark. And here is the I using the filter here. Yeah, without filter, I can be see like, okay, these are the UDP protocols, something like a TCP protocol, and different type of HTTP protocols, and all these things are presented here. So these are the protocols. So one by one, we have to be using the protocol. Like suppose when we stuck in on the TCP or IP protocol, so we have to be only shown or we have to only get the information about the TCP. If I use the DHCP protocol, so we have to be use only the DHCP. That means we have to be change our lease time or we have to be change our system to the dynamic IP or something like that one. So in that one case, we only we capture the DHCP packets. Third is the like suppose we are using the ICMP. So in the ICMP, we can only be pinged to the system. Like suppose we are using the ping request to the Google or any other different type of website. So we can only be capture the ping packet. So one by one, we have to analyze all types of protocols, like what type of protocols is working here, and all the information we have to be seen. Like we are using here TCP protocol, and it can using the 80 port number to the 7537. So 80 port number is the source port, and destination port is the 7537. So here is two flags are present. One is the synchronization, and second one is the ACK. So synchronization, that means you are connecting to this one port number. And the ACK is the acknowledgement of the previous one. Okay, here is the acknowledgement present in the next line, which is the, you can see the port number is to be different here. That means interchanging. So 7537 is getting your particular point, and after that it gives you the acknowledgement. That means, okay, I received your packet. So this is most important thing. That means you have to be know that how can you classify the information on your own basis. After that, there is all are the UDP. So in that one UDP, there is no acknowledgement, because UDP is the connectionless type of protocol. Understand what is the difference between here?
Yes,
because with
yes.
the help of information, you have to be capture all the packets, and you have to be give the information in your company or in your anywhere place with the help of the Wireshark. Because with the help of Wireshark, you can only be capture the information. If you want more information, so you have to be click on this one, and all the information related to the TCP are here. Open this one. Here source port is the 7537 is your source port. Destination port is the 80 stream index. That means we can send the packets. Index, that means the number only. TCP segment length, sequence number, and relate sequence number is this one. This is the sequence number. And the sequence number size is present in the bytes here. Next sequence number, also acknowledgement number is present. That means total size contains the 20 bytes. If you want to change into the bit form, so you can already be changed. If you want to see the information in the bits, bytes or something, you have to be go to the statistics and protocol hierarchy. It shows you the all the percentage, like 100%. That means related to the frame, you can send the 100% of packets. In the 100%, you can send the 3132 packets. In the byte form, you can change that one, some amount like 10 lakh or 1 lakh. In the bit form, 4000K you can send. So you can change it to in your own way. So these are the information which you get by using the information. So basically in the next class, I will show you that what type of protocol you have to be studied. All the protocol which we discussed today, like TCP/IP, DHCP, and that one. 1 minute, I'll show you. Yeah, TCP/IP, DNS, ARP, IPv4, ICMP, DHCP, HTTP. These 7 or 8 protocols we have to be learned one by one, that what type of packet captures we have to be captured, and also what type of information do we get by using these types of protocol. I already told you that mail protocols and something like that one, na, capture we need a particular server. So that would not be possible, but I will show you. Like if there is any server is to be captured and all these things. So what type of information do you get by using this one? And that one is a troubleshooting, which our last part. So we will cover almost till the Friday or Saturday, our course. If you have any type of PK files already present in your system, so you can also be show to me. Okay, if I found some type of PK file, so I will show you that, okay, this type of errors are present in the various types of systems. You can be analyze that one. Okay, any type of question which is present on the internet and all these things, so we have to solve that one also in our time period.
Okay. Awesome. Yeah.
So
yeah,
you
sure,
can
sure.
be practice at your home. If you have any query, so you can ask me in the next class. Okay.
Sure.
In the meantime, I will share you the doc file and the that one.
Okay,
class
sure.
record. Okay.
Class record. Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Thank you, Sunny.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye.